الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعهم والله وسلم تسليما كثيرا. Does everybody know what reverse engineering means? Reverse engineering? Reverse engineering. How do you know? Somebody? Go ahead. So you have a product, basically reverse engineering that you have a product, you wanted to trace it back to where it started, right? So you can redo it in a different way or a better way or avoid some mistakes, right? And this, not only in engineering, this became a term that you can use it in different things. And I'll tell you how important it is in our aqidah, in our deen, in a minute. Reverse engineering in education, for example, that a teacher comes in the class, teach the kids the subject, but the kids keep failing the exam. Right? So I would say those are kids, they don't have, I don't want to say a negative word, but they say these kids don't have it in them. Okay? But if you reverse engineer, you will see how the course was taught, or how the course was written. The course was made there. And you will find some issue all the time. So you go back again and do that. So when the education was only to dump information on people, okay, you will not have good results. But when you reverse engineer, you see what the community needs, and then you give them, then, or what the Muslims need, and you give them, then it becomes more beneficial. That's why Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to look at the Sahaba, what they need, and he gives the education based on that. You will ask him a question and based on their answer, he will correct the answer or not. So it becomes an interactive in teaching. So So he teaches them based on that. So he asked him a question, they said, yes, no, wrong, but this and that. And that's why in education, subhanAllah, here in the United States, for example, in the 40s, 50s, I forgot his name, but he's like the father of education here in the West. What he came up with, he said that education should be based on what the students suggest, or what the students want. So basically the teacher is learning from the students how to teach. Smart, right? So he said he teaches, he learns from the students. While he's teaching, he's actually learning how to be a better teacher. When the teacher goes with that mentality, he becomes more efficient. He becomes very beneficial. That's why we find Montessori system, we find the teachers when the kids love them in younger age. Why? Because they go down to the children, they love them, they relate to them. I love that teacher. But when they grow up, what happens? Because it's about the teacher now. I tell you, I'm authority, you listen to me. If you don't listen, get out, run out, this kind of thing. Okay? And our deen, this is important to, that's why professors and people who design, they go reverse engineer. They see why this course has not been working. Why people read Quran all the time, but they are not acting upon it? Why we know that Allah is Aziz al-Hakim, we know that there is hellfire, but we're not working on that. So have to go back. You go back, and you will find one thing. Always, we become the source of judging things. We become the source of judging things. I like or I don't like. It's not what Allah likes and what Rasulullah told us, that means it's for my own good and I go. I go with it. It's more of what I like and what I don't like. Now, when the aqidah, like I said, this is the point I'm trying to drive to. A couple of days ago, someone comes and my sister called me and said something in the WhatsApp group that we don't believe in the Sunnah, we believe in the Quran. And they're shooting what? A doubt. Doubt. Allah telling the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَالضُّحَى وَاللَّيْلِ إِذَا سَجَى مَا وَدَّعَكَ رَبُّكَ وَمَا قَالَ وَلَا الْآخِرَةُ خَيْرٌ لَكَ. We know the Surah, right? أَلَمْ يَجِدْكَ يَتِيمًا فَآوَى وَوَجَدَكَ عَائِلًا فَأَغْنَى. يعني الله made you rich. تمام؟ so good so far. So far, so good. How come the Prophet died when his sheep was collateral with the Jew to take some money to buy some food for his family? You understand? Question. So, wasn't he rich? He had the fifth of the state income. Why this? Come on, it is easy if you answer from the Sunnah. But that person did what? He denied what? The Sunnah. And he's telling you the Sunnah is wrong because of that. So you cannot give him hadith. Yeah, no, there are hadith also in Bukhari that said 1 month, 1 month, 1 month, we only eat that. What? And the Prophet said, and he does not sleep with any money extra at his house. So he might be needing in that time period. Until the next income comes, in that time period, it's okay. But that Sunnah only can prove. Correct? But that person now cornered you. So you need to do reverse engineering. Why he say what he say? Right? Why are they saying like that? Do they want to learn? Or do they want to create doubt for you? So I told my sister, if I answer them, would they believe in the Sunnah? If I answer that one, from Quran, would they believe in the Sunnah? Of course not. Or what they're going to do next? They'll give you another doubt. So, that's why I told her, two people I don't read the reply, I don't even bother. An atheist and the person who says I'm Qur'ani only. Go do your thing. But that's it. Because you're going to waste your time. Because the issue here, when you reverse it back, what make them ask what they mean? What is the drive? The drive is not learning. It's not looking for haqq. The drive is doing what? Is to create doubt for you. Right? I said, okay. Allah Azza wa Jal told the Prophet ﷺ, Wallahu a'asamuka min al-nas. Allah is going to protect you from people. So why you got injured in Uhud? Right? Why you struggled? Why Allah Azza wa Jal says in the Quran that the Prophet and the Sahaba, they were eager to say, when is the Nasr of Allah? Is he doubting Allah? That's one. And I can give you 10 ayats like this. Now we come back to the A'ilam Fa'aghna. What does Fa'aghna mean? I'm asking my sister. She said, they say, Allah make you rich. I said, why? Where does they bring the tafsir from? And where did this tafsir come from? Why does he have money? Rasulullah said, إِنَّ الْغِنَ غِنَ النَّفْسِ. Ghina means you do not need others. It doesn't mean you are rich. So why you say rich? So because that is what it means. Okay, I think it is different. I have the Sunnah, but you don't have anything. So why you bring this interpretation from where? You understand? But you have to be going back. You have to do some reverse engineering. Like, he's asking me this. Why he asked me this? What led to this? What kind of person is that? Then you will find the right answer. So I want to idea. Last thing I want to mention about believing in Allah himself. Does Allah exist or not? Is the question of the atheist all the time? There was a scholar from India, like about 200-300 years ago. Maybe you know the name. His name is Shah Dahlawi. Shah Dahlawi. His name is Shah Dahlawi. Dahlawi. Search him. You'll be surprised what he said 300 years ago. Right? He wrote some books that is not even published now. You can only find it handwritten. Alhamdulillah, I got one of those books a few weeks ago from somebody's private library in India. What he writes, he said, everybody got it wrong. Does Allah exist or not? We become the authority to decide. Actually, we are an extension of God's intention, of God's existence. Yeah, you should trace it back. There has to be a being that all beings are a result of. You have to trace it back. Yeah, I need you for something. And whom you need? Somebody above. And whom they need? And we as humans, who we need? Can we survive independently? There has to be a being, and that being has to have a higher being. And you keep going like that, you have to stop somewhere and say there is a God. Okay? And everything comes down from God. So basically, we are a reflection of God's existence. So we do not have the power to say God exists or not. We don't have that right. If you are a result of something, you cannot say, does that something exist or not? Because you will not see it with your eyes, you will not hear it with your ears, you will not comprehend it with your brain, because you are a result of his creation, that you are.
one path. So it's a little bit mystic, but he's right. So then we're going to go on. Who am I to decide if God exists or not? Huh? If we agree that God is the highest energy or highest entity, dead language, right? The highest thing. So what am I to say the scope of this being if I am a result of it? Shmukin. That means God exists, whether you like it or not. And he goes like this issue. So he goes back to it. How did I exist? And he keeps tracing it back. It has to start somewhere that you cannot know. And it's unknown. It's unknown. So the only way is when a messenger comes from that unknown, tells you something that makes sense. Right? That makes sense about that unknown. Yani there is God. And someone said, God is such and such and such. Said, yes, because this. Look at the mountain, look at this. Oh, there has to be higher. Okay, no, makes sense. So basically, it has to come from him what you need to understand about him. So you cannot initiate the discussion. I hope this is something that to trigger our heads a little bit, trigger your thinking. Fayani, our deen is the deen, subhanAllah, very simple. But once you challenge it, thinking that you have the authority to analyze, you fail. You will be out. That's why Allah Azza wa Jalla says, يهدي الله لدينه من يشاء. Allah is the one who guides whoever. That is the secret of that ayah. He said, why Allah comes people? He is the creator. He can do whatever he wants. You are judging God as he's another human being a little bit bigger. Huh? Yeah, sometimes people think like that. Why Allah is doing like this? I said, the only thing remaining is we have a court and he stands in the. Why we do this? He's not God then. That means I am the God. And it's a paradox. If you are going to make sense out of everything, means you are the God. Because if everything has to make sense to you, everything you have to see, everything you have to understand, everything has to make sense, logic, you are the God. He's not. So the secret is, you are questioned, he's not. You will be accountable, he's not. He can do whatever he wants, however he wants, you are not. And that's why Allah created us to worship him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So if we think slowly, you will find that I love to come for salah. I love to recite Quran. I love that Allah is beyond my understanding. You see the point now? Yeah, actually the idea of him being far away from my comprehension makes me comfortable. Because if he is someone I can comprehend and predict, he's not God. I hope this is clear now. So for him to stay unpredictable, not comprehended, لا تدركه الأبصار, I do not see him, I do not hear him, I cannot analyze his actions, that should be a source of comfort for me. Now we reverse it, right? It should not be a source of confusion. It should not be a source of confusion. You should be happy. You know, when you go with somebody who is your tour guide, what do you feel? You feel safe, don't you? Yes? When you go for somewhere and someone telling you, make right, make a left, you actually are not bothered about the map anymore. Yes? Why? Because that person is what? In charge. You're not going to question, oh, this restaurant is so good. You sure? Yeah, then go, okay, let's go eat. But when it comes for Allah Azza wa Jalla, I created you, I know you, then why? ولا إله إلا الله. So I hope today was a little bit here and there. But inshallah, Rabbil Alameen, we continue with this reflections, and may Allah make us among those who are guided to him, subhanahu wa ta'ala, in love with the sunnah of his Prophet, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, attached to his deen, live and love the book of Allah and the sunnah of Rasulullah. Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen, wa jazakumullah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. شكرا لكم وزيرك ان شاء الله.